What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another drawing tutorial. Today we are going to be doing the Alloraptor. So this is like one of those hybrid dinosaurs. I think it's a mix between the Allosaurus and a raptor, like a Velociraptor. I think Delta. I'm not sure. Let's go. I'm on the landscape page. Use a pencil and an eraser. Sketch it out lightly. And you can do ink on top afterwards. So we'll start with the eye. Center point here. Come up over to the right. Head's going to be up here. Standard kind of dinosaur eye. So we go up and down. Boom. And then this goes underneath. Curving line there. And then a real thin, like cat-like eye, like there. Okay, so around this then we got like some eyelid lines and details like this, right? So like an eyelid there, like a couple of these wrinkly sort of lines around his eye, and he seems to have like a big frown. So coming across this, right, so this frown comes down that way, kind of like up and around, back down side of his face. Kind of just makes him look real gnarly, right? And then this goes back up, kind of this way, goes over there, and this is a inside line as well. Right, so this has all bumps and stuff on it, right? So texture like this, some like texture going down here as well. This will go around and join his eye. Up the back. So this has all wrinkles, it's like an eye line, like a big frown. Bumps and things on top. Like that, so that's like this sort of shape goes around his eye. That, right, and then so he's got that big horn beside this, so one comes up this way, comes down there, and then it has like scales here. This joins the frown, so this horn is part of this sort of frown area here, and this can have like texture and stuff on it. And then he's another horn here. Texture and like a bump where it joins his skin. Sort of there. And then this will have all bumps and like that. And then his snout. So kind of bumps and wrinkles this way. So like up here, there's like a horn that like sticks up the middle of his nose, like there. And then goes down his snout, right? So he's got another horn here. Right, kind of like that. And then the horns on the other side are here. So the ones we could see on the other side of his head, like these just over the other side. Just come around here, and then this one, there, and then the back of his head goes that way. So then top lip and mouth, right? So comes this way, and his nostril is kind of in here. If I go too fast, just hit pause. We've got a nostril in here, dark inside, okay? Texture just around. And then another sort of section inside, you know, on the face. The Jurassic World dinosaurs kind of have this sort of roundy thing on their face. And you can do as much texture and stuff as you want, scales and dots and stuff. So, right, so then top lip curves this way. So, and then it kind of bends down, so it goes down, back up, and then into the corner of the mouth, like that. So in the back of the head, so this kind of line goes around the back, and then up towards the back of the skull, and then we got like all these bones and bumps and stuff here, and some lines coming down this way. Some texture. Texture always helps, and there are like some horns at the back over here on the other side of the head. So on the top lip, we've got like this gum line kind of thing. So this kind of thing. It's like his top lip or something. And you can add more texture if you want. Totally optional, of course. So, bottom jaw. So, bottom jaw. Mouth open, right? Lots of teeth. So, comes down. And around. Okay. And then the inside of this, bumping a couple of times, back around to there. And then we'll give him that bumpy sort of lip thing on the bottom jaw as well. Again, like texture, like scales, little clumped together scales like this, some skin lines and stuff around. Sometimes it's good to give him a scar, so I'm gonna give him like a scar here. Like so, looks like he's been in a few fights, right. Then teeth, right? So that's skin line sort of thing that they have in their mouths just there. Right, like that first. And then rows of teeth. So they start real small, sort of just underneath the eye here. Like so. And you just kind of keep adding them. And you can make them as sharp or as blunt as you want. And they kind of get bigger as we go out. Kind of look like shark fins or something like that. We just keep going. Adding, this is the front row. We'll add the back row as well. Like we can see like some underneath these at the back, the other side of his mouth. So we gotta add those as well. Bit of a gap here, and then right, so that's like the front row, and then we can see some in the back, and like there's this skin flap on the other side of his mouth just there, and it kind of goes back this way. So then we can see just some teeth like underneath there on the other side. So keep going. Yeah, they kind of get smaller then as we go back. And they kind of disappear into there somewhere. Okay, so tongue comes out from the back of the throat, sort of here. Yum. That, and then the bottom of it kind of here, so the middle line goes that way, and then like some hatching on the edge just to show that it's kind of raised up there on the edge. And then like side of his mouth or something here. And then more teeth. So we can see like the gum line of these teeth. So they kind of go into his mouth. So they've got like a round end. So we add just the tops of them first. And then we'll join them to his gum. Right, so what I mean, you just add this sort of round end to them. That, and then we go like kind of around the other way then. Underneath his tongue. And then give him the ends. So, and then we can see like some of the mouth. So this mouth comes down that way. And then the inside gum line. Like that, and gum line on the other side. Like so. And like maybe some like just some lines for the mouth or something where the tongue sort of connects. just in there. And then, you know, we'll just smooth up some lines around his head just to make it stand out a little bit. Like that. Maybe just thickening up the horn lines, make them stand out too. Like so. Right, buddy. So, neck. So we got like some horns on his neck and like scales and things, but we'll just do sort of general sort of line going this way. Kind of curves down there. And in the back of his neck. So we'll go from... So that's the back of his head. So we got like some more sort of bumps here. Kind of coming down this way, the back of his head. And then his neck will go down here. And so this is like bump this way then. There's all horns on his back as well, but we'll just sort of get the general shape just first. Can be a bumpy line, you know, because he's all scaly and stuff. And then, so we can see his shoulder. So it's like a line for his neck or something here. And then the shoulder is in here. And like his arm goes off that way. So this has like all sorts of scaly, the back of his arm here. Right, and his belly goes off this way. Okay. So then, details and scales and all bumps and stuff, right? So, back of his neck goes up here. And maybe some more lines that come down this way. Right, so like kind of like neck lines just going down here, which meet some more neck lines, which... start to go this way, and then these ones go up. Right, you'll have some texture in between them. And like these are quite dark, these necklines here. Right, and so you're just, you, so for like, for lines like this, you normally follow the shape. You know, like you go around the shape. So like his belly will have belly lines going this way. So you follow your shape, contour lines. Well, these are contours, but it just makes things look a bit more rounded. Vector lines or something is what you'd call them, maybe. And then his arm on the other side, sort of hanging down there. So, and he has spikes coming off his neck. Sort of these bumps and things. You can make them sort of like pyramids. So, and he does have rows of them, three rows, right? Three or four rows. So, like, join his shoulder. Go off back this way, right? So, there's like a row here, and then a row on his back. So, we'll do the row on his back. So, it's like. All these big spikes just sticking off his back. They kind of get smaller back here. And then each one of these corresponds to sort of bumping, like shell line. So, like, scaly back. Right, and then we got two more rows of all these spikes, right? So kind of start with these kind of triangular sort of shapes, right? They kind of like this, and then you make them 3D by adding this line in the middle, and then a line right like this. So that real easy way of doing them. So you're kind of going for like a pyramid, kind of flat pyramid kind of shape. Because they don't stick up too far on his back. You know, if you're feeling real adventurous, you can add some shadow to one side. Ooh. We forgot to do it on these ones as well. And keep going. There's another row here, so I'll just like mark them in. Kind of go up his neck. Up there. And then I'll make them kind of pyramid-like. That kind of thing, right? And then texture all along his back as much as you want. You can thicken up your edge lines as well. Sometimes that helps. So, like, just right at the edge of the character, if you darken it up, it just makes the drawing a little bit more interesting. It makes the texture lines on the inside of this line a little bit lighter looking, and makes the character stand out a little bit more, or whatever thing you're drawing. And this works really well if you're doing ink. Bit harder with pencil because you have to like do all that. So, and maybe some more texture just on this. think that's the best I can do. That's how to draw Alloraptor. Hope it's helpful, guys. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.